Shall we begin our evening meditation by singing the hymn Praise to the Lord? Psalm 118 verses 1 to 9. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love endures forever. When hard pressed, I cried to the Lord. He brought me into a spacious place. The Lord is with me. I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? The Lord is with me. He is my helper. I look in triumph on my enemies. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in humans. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. Good evening, friends. In this evening, let us meditate from Psalm 118. It is believed that this psalm was written after the construction of the temple, which was built by Solomon in the year 1950, and it was destroyed by the soldiers of Babylon in the year 586. So the scholars believe that after this temple was destroyed by Babylonian Empire, and the people were taken as captive. And again, when they came back, they started building it and finished in 516. And also they built the wall around the city, that is in 444 BC. So the scholars believe this psalm was written after the construction of the temple and the wall. Here we see the mood of this author. He was so happy. He wants to give thanks to the Lord for all the good things which they have received from God. If you go through the first 7 or 8 verses, there we can read that now he says that give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. God's love is a permanent one. It won't vanish. He will not leave us, or he will not leave us without any hope. That is why he says, though we were in Babylon, though we were in exile, though we were slaves, but God has brought us back. We were able to build this temple and the wall. It's all because of God's grace. So we need to thank him. Then further he says, let Israel say his love endures forever. Here we'll have to remember that the word Israel is not pertaining to the community or to the people, or it is to some particular clan. Here it is believed that this word Israel is applicable for all those who live in that land. So the author is not only telling his own people, but he is telling everyone who lives or lived in that place to thank him, praise him for this wonderful gift which he has given. Then he says, let the house of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Here this specifically it says the clan, house of Aaron. Why it is very specifically mentioned? Because we know that there were 12 tribes. One is Levites. They were serving in the temple. They were not having any land of their own. It was not given to them. But they were supposed to be taken care by the temple income. That is the reason the Bible always talking about 1/10. 10% of our offering should come to the temple or to the church, because the Levites were not given any land of their own. So they will have to be fed by the temple. That is the reason. Here he says that people, the clan of Aaron, they are very special people. They were called to serve God. So he says, now it is a time, these many years we were in exile, we were in slavery, there was no worship. We could not think about our God. Now we are free. Our temple is rebuilt. Come on, now let us thank God adequately. Let us share the joy and enjoy the life God has given to us. Then he says, I cried to the Lord. He brought me into a spacious place. Here this author is trying to tell that he was in prison. That means the prison means not this regular jail. Probably here he is talking about the slavery. Maybe he was in Babylon or in Egypt. That we are not very sure. But he is talking about the slavery. He says, I was pressed. I was in a very, very small place. But now God has brought me into a very, very spacious place. You know why he says? He says in verse 6, the Lord is with me, I will not be afraid. Who can mere mortals do to me? The Lord is with me, he is my helper. I look in triumph on my enemies. This psalm is a very, very triumphal and joyful psalm. Here we can see the joy overflowing the heart of this author. The simple reason is that he thinks that God is there with him. Nobody can do anything. Nobody can destroy him. That is why he was so happy. Probably he went through difficulties for some time. But now God has changed the situation. In our life also, for the past few months, we are going through difficulties. We do not know when things will change. But this psalm is encouraging us, and it is telling us God would bring us to a spacious place. Probably today we may think that we are hard pressed, as it appears in verse 5. We may think that we are not able to come out. We are suffering. We are hard pressed in a very small places. But remember,
the author is telling. God has brought him into a spacious place. We worship the same God. The God can change the situation. He will bring us to a spacious place. So as this author says, let we too say, I will not be afraid, as it says in verse 6, I will not be afraid. Let us not be scared of the situation which is prevailing. This all is very, very temporary. This will pass away very soon. It will never come back. It will never come back. God is going to do wonder in our life. Let us depend on Him. Let us believe Him. Let us trust in Him. Let us have faith in Him. I am very sure God would change the situation. Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for speaking to us through the author of this psalm. Lord, this author is so happy. He says that you have brought him into a spacious place. He was hard pressed. He was not able to move around. He was in slavery. But Lord, you have changed everything. Lord, this is the same situation in our life today. Probably we may not be slaves. We may not be there in exile. But in our own homes, we are confined to our own homes today. Because the situation is very bad. You know the reason. Lord, unless you help us, unless your grace is there with us, we cannot do anything. Lord, help us to rejoice in you. We ask you to change the situation so that in the days to come, like the author of this psalm, we also can praise your holy name. We can rejoice in you. We can tell others about your everlasting love. We commit all of us unto your keeping. May your peace, joy, protection, and health be upon each and every one of us. Bless this evening in a special way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you all. Good night.